remarkable woman. She is a remarkable woman who accomplishes so much as a strong woman. She is strong, but soft. Strong, but caring. Strong, but compassionate. She is a remarkable woman who accomplishes so much as a given woman in a selfish world. She gives to friends, family, and to everyone. She is a remarkable woman who is loved by so many people whose lives she has touched, including mine. I present to you our lovely mayor, Stephanie Rawlings-Blake.
Good morning, everyone. Can somebody tell Mother Nature that it's spring, please? I would love to have some warm weather. Isn't Miss Ernestine fabulous? I said, everybody, no matter what age you are, you need a role model. And if you need a role model for fitness, praise God, Miss Ernestine is there for you. You motivate me every single day, and it's such a pleasure for me because I got to introduce my daughter to Miss Ernestine, and her eyes just lit up, and I said, you know what? I'm not there yet. I'm working on being her fitness role model, but until I get there, there you are. So she was so pleased to meet Miss Ernestine, and again, you are an inspiration to us all. God bless you, and thank you so much for lending your talent and your spirit to our efforts today. So, you are joining us to celebrate public service. And who doesn't enjoy public service? Is there anybody? No, we all love it. The entire week, we are celebrating being part of our efforts to grow Baltimore by 10,000 families. And we want 10,000 healthy families. You know, this Great Recession put too much pressure on too many local governments. A budget deficit caused us to get creative and to do a lot more with a lot less. And we had to make tough choices. But thanks to the hard work of so many great public employees, we have made it through. Baltimore is getting better, it's getting safer, and it's getting stronger every single day. And recently, the Census Bureau announced that for the first time in nearly six decades, Baltimore's population has increased by over 1,000 people. That is a wonderful sign that we are headed in the right direction. We have to build on this momentum. We take advantage of this progress, and we've proposed a bold set of major reforms. And as part of the city's first 10-year financial plan, we're going to confront the city's serious financial challenges facing us over the next decade. Our tough reforms include proposed changes for city employees' pensions and benefits, our tax structure, vehicle fleet, zoning code, overall municipal operations. And that's going to change. It's going to amount to the most significant change in the way we do business and government in decades. And if we enact these tough reforms, if we make these changes, Baltimore can grow again. We can be the city that we know we need to be. We will eliminate a $750 million structural deficit and make sure that we're protecting our basic services instead of trying to figure out. I was talking to a community group the other day, and it seems like when you have these structural deficits, when you're always facing cuts, you feel like you're robbing Peter to pay Paul, you know, to figure out what you can cut so you can give a little bit there. And I said, you know, we need to be in a place where we can plan for our investments, plan for the city that we know we want to be. And in order to do that, we have to make some tough changes. So it will allow us to make new investments in neighborhood infrastructure, including repairing more roads, improving our city facilities, rebuilding 10 recreation centers, and tearing down more than 4,000 vacant homes, all while reducing homeowner property taxes by more than 20% over the next 10 years. I know somebody's happy about the property tax reduction. So with these reforms in place and our continued dedication of all of our public employees, we can achieve and we will achieve great things and get Baltimore growing again. But in order to do that, you know, they say you need body, mind, and spirit. We need all of our employees to be healthy. We can make the reforms, but if we don't have if our employees aren't ready for the challenge, and that means body, mind, and spirit, we're not going to be able to take full advantage of it. So healthy employees are more effective at their jobs, and it helps reduce our costs. You know, we have so many of the things that we can do to cut costs. You know, everybody's turning the light switches off and cutting your computers off and doing that type of thing and trying to find ways to be more efficient. But how we take care of our bodies controls a lot of the cost of government, and that's something that we have control over every day. We performed an evaluation of the health of our workforce, and the news wasn't good. Our workforce is unhealthy, and that the condition of our workforce is driving up the cost of city government significantly. Nearly 50% of city employees and retirees have critical or chronic illnesses or are at risk, and we can't reap the benefits of all the reforms. So we're making all these tough choices, we're making sacrifices, but if we don't change the way we're living, it'll all be for naught, because the health costs are gonna eat up all the savings that were made. So that's why we are glad to be a partner with Kaiser Permanente and their mobile health vehicle, which is here even though you can't see it because of the lovely trees. The mobile health vehicle is beginning its Know Your Numbers tour right here at City Hall. In the next 3 months, they will visit more than 30 work sites to offer health screenings and to raise awareness of blood pressure and body mass index. I hate that number, but it's so important. I'm being honest. It is important, right? But it's rough. When I was first, you know, trying to figure out, you know, what was my goal and trying to get healthy, I'm telling you, once I saw what my body mass index was supposed to be, I was looking for every excuse, every way out. I was looking for the black people's BMI. I was looking for the woman's BMI. I said, there has to be something that'll bump me up a little bit. You know, give me a little room. But the truth of the matter is, you have to, just like we're being honest about government, we have to be honest with ourselves. And the thing is, I knew in my family, everything that you can get from being overweight runs in my family. Everything. Whether it's diabetes, heart disease, cancer, high blood pressure, everything that you can, that being overweight contributes to, runs in my family. So what do you have to do? You have to look in the mirror, put your big girl pants on, and get busy. And that's what I had to do, because I had control over that one thing. You don't have control over who your parents are. But you have control over what you do with the cards that you are dealt to make sure that you reduce your risk of disease. And that's what we had to do. And knowing your numbers is a key part of it. So with this partnership with Kaiser Permanente, we are addressing the growing incidence of chronic diseases that I talked to you about. And I want to thank Kim Horn, president of Kaiser Permanente Mid-Atlantic Region, for partnering with us. So, in addition to the health screening, there will be a series of wellness activities and events. On Tuesday, we're going to have the Spring Into Wellness Health Fair at War Memorial. On Wednesday, we'll be dancing in the street with Zumba. Who's ready for some Zumba? I am. On Thursday, we are hosting There's an App for Everyone Technology Fair at War Memorial. And I totally believe in using the apps to help you with your weight loss goals. They're wonderful. And there is one for everyone. And on Friday, agencies throughout the city will host employee appreciation events all day. So pick up the flyers for more details or visit the Department of Human Resources Facebook page. In a moment, I will step into the mobile health vehicle to have my numbers checked. I'm excited about that. Everything but my BMI did not agree to that. I hope you are here to do the same. Oh, I see Councilman Scott. Are you going to get your numbers checked today, too? Yeah, you're good? That's a yes. You're going to go get your blood pressure, your cholesterol, all of those things. Wonderful. All right, so before I learn my numbers, it is an honor and a privilege for me to introduce our partner, Kim Horn, President Kaiser Mid-Atlantic, to say a few words about our partnership. Kim.
Thank you. Good morning. What a pleasure to be here today. Wasn't Ernestine amazing? We were all looking up your Facebook page, and learning about you, very inspiring. On behalf of Kaiser Permanente, it's my pleasure to be here with Mayor Rawlings-Blake to begin the citywide campaign about screening and health promotion. We are launching or created the Know Your Numbers tour to offer health screenings through our mobile health van. And I please hope that you go over and look at our van. And that van will be at 30 locations across the city. Chronic conditions, as the mayor indicated, including obesity and hypertension, is not only a Baltimore problem, it's a national problem. And it affects millions and millions of people across our country. Today, Kaiser Permanente is here to help Baltimore City employees and Baltimore City citizens to know their baseline numbers. You can't do anything about it if you don't know where you start. Whether it's through health screenings or providing healthy living information or through our number of sites all across the region, Kaiser Permanente is committed to total health for everyone. We are grateful for this partnership and we look forward to working with Mayor Rawlings-Blake to increase awareness and improve the health of the city of Baltimore.